it's going. How are your rides this weekend?
We're on the way home from Aaron's Three Championships, and we had a total of 9 horses and I think 7 riders. And overall, it was really good. I'm really proud of everybody. Let's see, I personally rode 2 7-year-old thoroughbreds that I have had in my program for a little while. They went in the training horse championships.
a coach, how do you plan to improve both of your horses and your students for their next outings?
So, King, King is a super nice horse, and he's got some really great movement. He has a fantastic trot lengthening, a fantastic canter medium, and I just have to work on getting him a little bit more connected through his back into your hand. So, I'm actually going to play with his bidding a little bit and see if I can put, like, a chunkier bit in his mouth so he'll want to pull. He's almost too soft in the bridle, so if I could just improve that on the flat, and then that horse also tends to just want to be a little bit high through his head and through his neck in his show jumping, which he jumps clean, very careful, but I'm just trying to help him change his shape to be a little bit rounder through his back between the fences, to see if I can just help him encourage him to get stronger all the time. Flynn, but, you know, he's no worse for the wear, and he'll just keep working on the flat. He's had scored a 32, I think, on the flat, which was really good. I was happy with that, but you know, I think I can shave off another 2, 3, 4 points on that horse. Just need to kind of keep developing him. I get a lot of comments on that horse, and he tends to be a little hurried, so we just need to keep him in front of the leg, but slow at the same time, so that's how he's working. Overall, the rest of my students, you know, Ainsley and I are going to work together on the flat a lot, and Nicholas and I are going to work together on the flat a lot, and we're going to be working on softening those horses through their top lines, getting them a little bit longer and lower through their necks so they can be a little freer in their backs, and that will really quickly improve their dressage scores. Devin, on her two horses, since she'll probably be taking over the ride on Zen here for a while, that horse needs to focus mostly on his style jumping and carrying a rhythm all the way around the fences. And her mare, Kite, is in the training right now. I'd really like them to be able to move up, you know, at some point this year. So I just want to see them continue to develop, especially in the show jumping, where the mare can get a little flat and bolt a little bit at the fences. We need to work on keeping them really round and supple all the way through the course and not have those moments that we charge the fences. Everybody. Emma and Elena, both of them have done a really good job. Elena just had a couple, just didn't quite all put the pieces together this weekend, but they really are all there for her. She just needs work as a competitor. She needs more experience competing. And that's really big, that you can do all the training you want at home, but there's a very big difference between working at home and showing up and competing at a show and being able to put all the pieces together when you're actually at a horse show. So that's what Elena needs to work on. I just want to get her out competing as much as possible. And Emma is in a very good, consistent program where she's riding twice a week, and we're really focusing on the flat work for her and just keeping her in that mare really relaxed and forward and through, and just keeping them calm together. Lauren. Lauren's doing a great job. Lauren is going to kind of take the summer off. She doesn't like to compete in the heat. I understand she's from the northwest. She's from Seattle. Yeah, it's from Seattle. So she doesn't really like the heat. She did a great job this weekend, but we're just going to keep her going this summer and keep her confidence up. We're going to do a lot of show jumping lessons and probably try to go out to Chattahoochee Hills and do some of their Twilight Jumper series and just keep her clicking along on the flat. She's done a great job. All of a sudden, it's really coming together for her, and she wants to aim for her Lisa Seeger Adult Amateur Award at the end of the year, so we'll be making sure we have all the pieces together for that.
What's next on your schedule?
Well, we have just a few days of downtime here. We've got 5 days, and then I have a training camp that's starting. So we're going to be doing a training camp for
8 days.
Starting this coming Saturday, and then running all the way through the following Sunday on Father's Day. And so we're going to be working. I'm going to be teaching everyone most of that. I have Jill Henneberg, my good friend and my personal coach, coming in. That's going to be teaching pieces